صباح good morning, sorry. I was recording in Arabic, so my Arabic is still continuing. Good morning, Munir Ajam, with another video on project management. A couple of days ago, one of the people who have been following these videos asked me to talk about ethics in project management. Now, I know there are a lot of organizations out there, and these organizations have ethical codes and code of conduct, whatever. Unfortunately, you know, sometimes I feel like these organizations themselves, they don't follow their own code of ethics, so I'm not going to go there. And I'm not going to talk about those things. I'm going to talk from the heart, and as you have been used to my videos, I talk openly, and I will talk from my own experience and talk directly. So no theory, you know, academic lectures, or anything like that. In terms of ethics, maybe we need to talk about legality and ethics, and of course, you know, legal issues are things that are by law. So anything that the law in a given country specify, usually in project management, we must follow. So depend on where you are in the world, you have to follow the law of the land. Yeah, there is no avoiding of that. Obviously, some people avoid, but if you're lucky, you stay out of jail. Then the other part of ethics, and in my view, ethics, professional ethics. We're talking about professional ethics. And professional ethics is really two parts. The first part is the typical ethical issues, you know, such as crime, lying, stealing, those kind of things. Of course, this is one part of the human ethics, regardless where you are in the world. Unfortunately, sometimes some of our Western friends like to lecture us is they, you know, believe like in some of the developing countries is bribes is common. Yeah, but I mean, look, you know, maybe in these countries bribe is common for the people to at the lower level so they can eat and survive. And of course, some are more greedy than that. You know, but in some of the top countries in the world, you know, presidents have known to be corrupt. So please don't lecture us in terms of ethnicity. Yeah, ethics has nothing to do with ethnicity. Ethics is global, you know, human ethics is the same everywhere you go. So from that perspective, so this is one part of professional ethics, is the general common ethics, such as I mentioned, lying, stealing, bribing, all of these issues. The other part to me is professional, more professional practice. So it has to do with the practice of project management, since we're focusing on project management. Unfortunately, sometimes you have people who have, they don't have the right competence in what they do, or they are even incompetent. And incompetent being that mean they act like they are, they know it all, but they're really idiots. Excuse my directness and openness here. So with this situation, if these people are incompetent, if someone who's not competent and recognize that, there's nothing wrong with that. Yeah, I mean, I'm a civil engineer by education. But I have left civil engineering 20 plus, I lost count years ago. So I lost my engineering skills. And right now, I am not a competent civil engineer. So that doesn't mean I'm an idiot. It just means I just don't know. I don't have that experience anymore. And obviously, ethics prevent me from practicing as an engineer. So from that perspective, so professional ethics, so not competent is okay as long as I'm willing to spend the time and energy to learn if I have to, or if I don't have to, I just don't practice. The other part is that incompetent is really bad. Yeah, and unfortunately, some people who are very incompetent who are incompetent, there is no very, they like to hide their incompetence by taking shortcuts or not doing the right thing. Yeah, so basically, here we're talking about doing things right, yeah, and doing the right things. So both two things here are different. You know, maybe this is borrowed from total quality management. So we want to do what's right, and we want to do it right. Okay. So with that in mind, we shouldn't be hiding information. We shouldn't be taking shortcuts because just we don't know. If we are willing to take these shortcuts, do we even know what the consequences are? Yeah. So. Maybe here it's time, I think it's been the point I explained, so it's time for an example. Years ago, as a young engineer, after my bachelor and before my master's, I was working for a geotechnical environmental consultant in the U.S. Okay, so this is a U.S. story, okay? And so it's not like Ethiopia or Syria, yeah? It's the US. And part of our jobs in this consultancy depend on what type of assignment we're working on. In one situation, I had an assignment where we are working at let's say at a major university. They were building a complex of buildings, four or five buildings. And in this situation, you know, of course, you have a contractor doing the work, and my company was hired to do the quality control. So our job in quality control in geotechnical area is basically to monitor anything has to do with surface or subsurface installation, such as foundation or piling or backfills or things of that nature. Now, there were more than one of us, and we obviously rotate sometime. And not only on this project, we work similar project. Later on, we discovered that a friend of mine, a colleague of mine, that she was basically forging a test, because we had to do soil tests. So we take a sample from the soil and we test it. In situation, for example, in backfill. Yeah. So let's say during a day we have to take 10 tests. My memory failed me on the numbers. Basically, she probably do 6 or 7 and then forge the rest. Now, putting forging report, that means she is verifying in a given area of the site installation was done according to specification. And this is not true. I mean, maybe it is. Maybe it is. Now, if the contractor did not know she's doing this, they probably are working well and nothing. There is no damage done. But if they know maybe she's not doing this, yeah, what would prevent them from taking shortcuts themselves? What prevent them from doing backfill not according to specification? What would prevent some of them paying her, yeah, to even falsify failed tests? And they, obviously, I mean, again, in this situation, I have no idea what happened. I don't know if there were ever damage done or anything of that nature. But what we know, whether damage was done or not, is obviously this is a foundation for damage. This is a foundation that thinks with that, you know, could result in failure or damage to structure that is built on this soil condition and foundation. And maybe in some situation, I know it might be an extreme in regard to this specific example, even this. But what I'm saying is that even in this situation, maybe this is not something that we do, something that results from this because it's simple. But if she is willing to forge information on something as simple as that, what would prevent her from forging or falsifying reports on something that more severe than this that could actually result in human life? Yeah, I will leave you with that to think about. Good day.